ದೇವ ಭವಂತಂ ವಂದೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಮನಮಾನಸ ಮಧುಕರ ಮರ್ಪಯ ನಿಜ ಪದ ಪಂಕಜ ಮಕರಂದೇ ಮನಮಾನಸ ಪಂಕಜ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ದೇವ ಭವಂತಂ ವಂದೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ದೇವ ಅಯದ್ದಪಿ ಸಮಾಧಿಷು ವಿಧಿರಪಿ ಪಶ್ಯತಿ ನ ತವ ನಖಗ್ರ ಮರೀಚಿ ಯದ್ದಪಿ ಸಮಾಧಿ ವಿಧಿರಪಿ ಪಶ್ಯತಿ ನ ತವ ನಖಗ್ರ ಮರ್ಪಯ ನಿಜ ಪದ ಪಂಕಜ ಮಕರಂದೇ ಮನ ಮಾನಸ ಪಂಕಜ ಮಕ ಹೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಭಕ್ತಿರುದಂಚತಿ ಯದ್ದಪಿ ಮಾಧವ ನ ತ್ವಯಿ ಮಮ ತಿಲ ಮಾತ್ರಿ ಮಸಾರ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ದೇವ ಭವಂ ತಮ ವಂದೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ದೇವ ಭವಂ ತಮ ವಂದೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಗೌರವರ ದೇಹ ಬಿಲಸಿತಲೆ ಸಮ ತ್ರಿಭುವನ ಪಾವನ ಕೃಪಯಲೆ ಸಂ ತ್ರಿಭುವನ ತಂ ಪ್ರಣಮಾಮಿ ಚ ಶಿಶ ಚಿತನಯಂ ತಂ ಪ್ರಣಮಾಮಿ ಚ ಜಯ ಸಚಿನಂದನ ಜಯ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ
अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तनारे कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय भक्ताय भक्त्या विहीना पराध लक्ष्य क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृतामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं न मां चरणं
So the new initiates, now we will give the new names.
Yes, tell them to stand up one by yes. One.
Danny, can you stand up? Danny, what is that? The new name is Dayanidhi.
Dayanidhi. Now he has been given Dayanidhi Prabhu. He was one of the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, serving always like Vidyanidhi. You know Vidyanidhi? Vidyanidhi, the guru of Gadadhar Pandit. So Dayanidhi, also he is called Dayanidhi sometimes. Or there was a very good associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So his name has been kept Dayanidhi Prabhu. From today you will all call him like Dayanidhi Prabhu.
Greg.
We are calling him Gadadhar Das. Very good man. Gadadhar Prabhu. Then
Sin.
Sean.
Very good. What name?
Sudam.
He has been given Sudam Nam. Sudam Prabhu ki. He was the most Krishna in Braja. Also Sudam was in Dwarkapuri. But Krishna left Dwarka Sudam only due to his Sudam friend in Braja, very near and dear to Krishna.
Anandini.
Radhika is himself Anandini. He gives so much pleasure to Krishna. So he is Anandini. And you are Anandini Devi or Anandini Dashi.
Malini. Madhuri.
Oh, Madhuri. Very good name, Madhuri. Madhuri ki. We will call you Madhuri. One of the good friends of Radhika, Shakhis of Radhika.
Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Chandramukhi Devi ki.
Yes.
Chandramukhi means his mouth even more beautiful than moon, and she is only Srimati Radhika. So Chandramukhi is one of the name of Srimati Radhika. We will call you Chandramukhi. You are also so beautiful. And then?
Raglekha
Devi ki. Raglekha. One of the best among the Sakhis. Lekha means to be expert in what? Chitra.
Painting.
Art. So much. So he used to give the painting of Krishna to Srimati Radhika. And that is why he is called Raglekha. Raglekha ki.
Narada Rishi.
Oh, Narada Rishi. He is very, very sincere and senior devotee. But he wanted he should change his falling guru and be helped. So I am helping him. And I have changed his name, Nanda Kishore Prabhu. Nanda Kishore is name of Nanda Shan. Nanda Nandan is called Nanda Kishore, but more good than Nanda Nandan also. Nanda Nandan may be very little, but this Nanda Kishore always in Kishore days. And he is one of the Dash, Nanda Kishore Dash. Are you happy by this?
Yes, very. One more. Dayal Chaitanya.
Who is Dayal Chaitanya Prabhu? Chaitanya Das is good name. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. So Chaitanya Prabhu. You are satisfied by this name? Today is a very auspicious day. Birthday of Vishnu Priyati. This is the embodiment of Prema Bhakti. At the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they like to honor Vishnu Priyadi. Though he was like Shatthama, incarnation of Shatthama of Dwarkapuri, he has come to Krishna, Gaur Lila in Nadi, and she is the incarnation of Shatthama, and first wife of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Lakshmi Priya, is the incarnation of Rukmini Devi, manifestation of Rukmini Devi. When Lakshmi Priya left this world, he was merged into Vishnu Priya Devi. Perhaps you know that how she was immersed in the devotional services. At first, when Lakshmi Priya Devi left this world, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu preaching in East Bengal, he was so much feeling separation for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at that Mai Pandit. He could not tolerate, she could not tolerate. And he left his body, her body. After that, Sachima was feeling so much that wife of my son has gone. She wanted that a new wife should come, but equally beautiful to Nimai. He was so beautiful and he was so much qualified. So any girl should be taken who should be very immersed in devotional activities and very much beautiful and having so many qualities. She was going to Delhi to take bath in Ganges, very near her. Delhi, he used to see that a very beautiful girl of 16 or 17 going Delhi to Ganges. At the same time, when Ma Sachi was going to take bath, with so honor for Ganges, so honor for Krishna. After taking bath, he used to worship Krishna there and used to touch the feet of Sachi Mata daily. Daily he used to touch. So much honor for Sachi Devi. So, seeing and coming in contact, he thought that it will be very better that this girl is married to my Nimai. So he expressed this idea to any Brahmin named Sanatan, I don't know. Sanatan. And he was like
matchmaker.
He used to do these things usually.
Marriage making.
They were marriage making persons. called Purohit. In India, they are called like Purohit. All go to them and tell that my son is to be married, my daughter is to marry, and they help him by seeing their, counting their Rashi, astrological things, and everything. And if they allow, and they will tell to their father and margin and guardians, they will certainly follow their words. So this Sanatan Prabhu went there. He was like Gargacharya of Krishna. So he went to that, the father of and mother of Vishnu Priya Devi. They never expected that a very beautiful and very qualified in whole Bengal or India will have such a husband for our girls. They at once became so glad and accepted this offer. and very near date, the date was fixed for marriage. Very rich persons in at that time in Navadvip town. When he heard that Nimai Pandit is going to be married, he told that whole expense of marriage, I will bear. Because he is my Shiksha Guru. He was learning some Sanskrit from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his boyhood time. So now he became so rich and he told that, I will bear the expenses of whole thing. So beautiful marriage party. Went to marry. Very good festival and everything was done. Very beautiful and qualified. Vishnu Priya Devi came in the house of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When they sat together, unparalleled, beautiful, and all become happy. Whole Navadvip came, all ladies and gentlemen came and they blessed them. In the meantime, Mahaprabhu went to Gaya and he changed his all moods, crying, weeping, rolling down on the earth, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. He had no talk with Vishnu Priya. But Vishnu Priya always serving from far away by cooking, by giving all the things which are helpful for him. But only that, he was not in his conscious Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, out of senses, always bitterly crying. When he returned from Gaya, he stopped to teach in his school. His school was stopped. He told that I don't know any meaning of any sutra, word, or anything except Krishna. I see that all words denotes Krishna. And when he used to see any words, he began to cry. Krishna always came in his mind. If he sees any cow, he began to weep loudly. He used to remember Krishna, cow herding. If he used to see anything resembling to Vrindavan, even flowers, cuckoos, peacocks, Ganges, he thinks that it is Yamuna flowing. So he was always crying bitterly for Krishna. Where you, Krishna? Otherwise my breast will worn and torn. I cannot live without you. So he was changed in this. So in the night he used to go to Sri Vasangan. They are chanting, remembering and kirtaning so much whole night with bhakts. And when coming here in the courtyard of his mother, he began feeling separation from Krishna. Sometimes he used to remember the cow grazing, sometimes playing with gopis, playing with gopis, so many things. So Vishnu Priya has not a moment time to meet and to be familiar and talking and all these things. So it went on 3-4 years like this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made up his mind that I must give up worldly things. My beloved wife, mother, everything I should give. Even I will have to give Navadvip Dham. so many friends and scholars and all of us. If I am here, then I cannot do my things to sprinkle Krishna prem to whole world, and I cannot taste my three wishes. And I see here, living here, the inhabitants of Navadvipa are quarreling with me. They cannot understand my mood. When I'm in what mood, they cannot realize. Sometimes a new teacher came, or a student, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was moving in very deep thought of Braja. And at that time he was thinking that Krishna is so cheater and he is naughty. He tells lie, he cheats Gopi. So he at that day he was thinking that, oh, I have not connection with Krishna. But better if I have connection with gopis. Because he gives so many problems to gopis. So he was doing gopi, gopi, gopi. Emerging in Braj Bhav, gopi bhav. But that student could not understand. He said, why you are telling gopi, gopi, gopi? Why not Krishna, Krishna, Krishna? Where in Shastra it has been written that you should repeat or you should chant gopi, gopi, gopi? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thought that, oh, he is sometimes something inclined towards Krishna. He is the Krishna Pakshiya. And he took a stick, very mota wala, very thick, and he ran after that person. Oh, he ran away so quickly, telling that, I will see you. I have come to your home and that is why you are so strong and going to beat me. I have done nothing against you and yet you are doing like so. So I will go and make a party of students and will attack you and give a good lesson. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thought that, I have come to taking all these sufferings of whole jivas and they are making offenses to me, so I should not give this chance. I came to remove all the sufferings, sorrows and to engage them in Krishna service, but I am doing against, so I should give up all these things. Whole Navadvipa, my wife, my children, my home and everything, so that they will afterwards, sometime, they will be favorable to me. And then they will think that, oh, all the kings, all the Narada persons are coming in the lotus feet of this Nimai Pandit. Then they will realize, oh, he has so qualities. Now he is in renounce order. A sannyasi should be think to be like Krishna, Narayan. So they will anyhow do pranam to me and then they will be out of offenses. But this was only artificial and outward reason. But main reason was that if I am not giving up all these things, how can I test three wishes? How can I take the mood of Radhika? And how can I give whole world Krishna prem if I am, as a householder, always binded in household duties? I cannot do. That is why he made up his mind that tomorrow in the midnight I will cross the Jamuna, Ganga, and I will go to Kantak Nagari and there I will take renounce order, sannyas. and then I will go to Vrindavan. I will never be in Navadvip or anywhere. I will go in same Vrindavan where I can meet Krishna. This decision was kept so secret. But anyhow, four friends of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew it. Anyhow. That was Nityananda Prabhu, Chandrasekhar Acharya, Gadadhar Pandit, and anyone else. When he was going to take sannyas, in the evening he went to meet with all the villagers in Navadvip, all the learned persons, all the devotees, all were honoring him. They were not imagining that even today he will give up all these things and will go to take renounced order. Nothing to have take suggestion from anyone. It depends on the heart of devotee. What should I do for Krishna? Whether I should be in this worldly family, as a person of family, or I have to take renounced order. It depends on the strongness of his heart. If anyone has past impression, he can take it. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made up his mind very strongly that tomorrow in the night I will give up the whole world. Vishnu Priya could not imagine, but he was knowing, knew that he only has love for Krishna. And being in the same home, always feeling separation and separation. Sometimes Chaitanya Mahaprabhu calling, Krishna, Krishna, where you are, and used to fall on the ground. But she could not help. She could not take in his arms. Only Nityananda Prabhu sometimes used to take in his arms. Otherwise not. So living together but feeling some separation, no talk in day and night, morning, evening, nothing. Vishnu Priya always thinking, always remembering him, always in the mood of serving. Sometimes he began to weep, then mother, Sachi, used to console her. Last day, she was going to take bath in Ganges, and she got an injury in his feet, sometimes knocked down. No? And some blood came out. She was thinking that for 4 years, more than 12 years, I'm going to Delhi to Ganges. Never I felt like so. Why? Today something wrong. When he was bathing, the same nose ring went in the Ganges. She searched so much but could not find. Now he was wetting her head with her. What will she do? I don't know. She began to weep. Weeping, she returned to Maya Sachi Devi and told all these things and began to weep, sitting in the lap of Vishnu Priya, Sachima. She tried to console but could not control. She began to weep herself, Sachi Maya. So both were weeping. When it became night, Nimai Pandit was today so happy, so happy. He took some garland, he took some betel nut, and decorated himself his very beautiful hairs, curved hairs. And he went in the home of Vishnu Priya Devi in night. When it was about midnight. Today he was loving so much to Vishnu Priya Devi that Vishnu Priya Devi could not imagine, in 4 years I have not received any
affection to me.
But today, why? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu decorated his hair, her hair, with his own hands. Very beautifully he decorated. And he gave some flowers and garland is his here. Made so beautiful, gave battle net. And today, very affectionately, talking so many things. But she was weeping in her heart. That is, this is the last day perhaps. Why he is affectioning me so much? It is a very strange thing. If lamp is going to be
extinguished.
It goes like dhap, dhap, and then forever finished. We have seen that those persons who are ready to die, they are lying down on the bed, unconscious for 2, 3, 4, 5 days. At last, they call all their
relatives
and they talk something. They think that, now he has become well. But after a moment, and goes away. So Vishnu Priya Devi is thinking that today I have lost my nose ring, I have some injury today, and seeing all these things which are not usual, so what will be today of my this sindur, you know? I don't know anything. She was thinking like this. Being in the lap of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nimai Pandit, very closely, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did like in his arms, but yet he was feeling so much suffering. No happiness, nothing. I don't know what she was thinking of, and drinking in the ocean of separation. At once Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Krishna, he called Yogamaya, and he ordered that you should go on the eyes of Vishnu Priya. Yogamaya became of lakhs and lakhs quintal, so much heavy. And she wanted not to sleep, but yet she sat so
soundly.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw towards her one time. And he removed his eyes and began to walk towards the door. He saw that mother, Sachi Devi, is there standing like wood, not doing anything.
Statue.
Like it. Also, the tears were dry. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did parikrama of Sachi Maya and took the feet dust off, and no song, he left his home forever. Ganges was slowly, very gently flowing, but it was very cold day. Coldest day. Rain was going something. So very night in midnight. Where Krishna you are telling, and he jumped in Ganges. And he crossed the river and went about 20 miles from Navadvip. And there he came out of the Ganges and went to one Mayavadi sannyasi. What name?
Keshav Bharati.
He was well known to Kesava Bharati. Kesava Bharati used to come to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he was Nimai Pandit. And he was loving so much to this boy. He was as yet sannyasi. But he was not Pakka Mayavadi sannyasi. He has taken initiation in Mayavadi sannyasi, but he was really a very good devotee. And he gave the mantra of Gopi Bhav mood. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him that what mantra you are going to give me? I think that this mantra you want to give me. And told in his
ear.
Yes. And made his disciple him. And then took. When the barber came and wanted to shave, but he was weeping, weeping, weeping for whole day, he could not shave till evening. At last Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ordered Yogamaya, then entered Yogamaya in barbers, and then he could shave. In the evening, he gave sannyas mantra to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. As soon as he received the mantra, oh, he was crying, "Oh, Krishna, where you are, where?" And he started to go to Vrindavan. But Nityananda Prabhu, cunningly, he brought him to Shantipur. And after being there, whole Navadvipvasi, lakhs and lakhs person, and from remote villages, they used to come to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in shape of now Krishna Chaitanya. Now he became sannyasi. His mother came, all came. Mother told, she was so much weeping, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, "I've done mistake, wrong. You have brought up me to this age, but I could not serve. My father has gone, my brother has taken sannyas, and even myself weeping and become sannyasi. So I could not serve. If you like, I can give up sannyas and I want to serve. She began to weep like this, and one hand on the head of new sannyasi boy. She told, "Don't break the rule and regulations of Ved and Upanishad. If you have taken sannyas, I want that you should observe the rules and regulations of sannyasi. But only one. I want one thing, that you should not go very far away in Vrindavan, but you can live in Jagannath Puri, so that sometimes I may go there, or I will have your kushal varta, your information, good news, from so many devotees coming and going to, because Puri is not so far away." He told you, yes. He told that you should be here for 3-4 days. I will cook and only you will have to take that. So he used to cook and give. You know that all the dogs even, all the girls, all the boys, all the olds and old ladies and gentlemen came to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Only one could not come. And who? What he had done, that she could not come. She knew that if I will go, then it may be that my husband will be offended. So I should not make any problem for him. I can bear, tolerate all these things, but I don't want to see him unhappy. So everyone went there. Can you imagine the mood of Vishnupriya at that time? Whole village, Naudeep town, was vacated. No one was there. But only she was there, weeping, weeping, weeping. She cannot come. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Puri. He never returned to Navadvipa. Never meeting was done after all with Vishnupriya. But what was the condition of Vishnupriya Devi? Always weeping, feeling separation. She used to chant Hare Krishna name. Not Gaur, not Gaur, not Chaitanya. Because his husband had told her any time to chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna
Krishna, Krishna Hare, Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. Always feeling separation for Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But always remembering that he has told me to chant Hare Krishna. So weeping whole day, especially in morning, serving Narayan after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has been left to help Sachi Devi. And from morning till midday, chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Ram,
washing with her tears, taking one rice here. Again, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. No bead, mala and anything. Only with rices. Up till midday, how much she can count? She took it and washed, and it cooked, it was cooked. Any shark, leaves of vegetables, like palan saag or anything, she cooked. Or what he has managed Sachi Devi for this. Sachi Devi has given all his household duties to Ishan Prabhu. He was serving. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has also ordered him to take care and look after his home and these two ladies. So he was managing everything. It was cooked and it was given to house deity, that is Narayan, Shalagram, or Adhokhaj Vishnu Tattva, which was coming from generation, from his father, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So it was, she used to give to Sachima, she used to offer. And after offer, Vishnu Priya Devi used to give whole to the Sachimaya. She used, remembering his son, weeping something. And some portion he used to, very little, to Vishnu Priya Devi. Very little she used to take, only to maintain life, nothing else. Whole day chanting, remembering. Son even could not see the face, even his feet, what to about face. So Narottam Thakur came, Srinivas Acharya, Shyamananda Prabhu came, Jiva Goswami came there. Only they saw, took darshan of her lotus feet only. Not fashion even. Always kind, bitterly. So she is called what? She is called Prema Bhakti Swarupani, incarnation of, embodiment of Krishna Prema. So this is the life history of Sachi Vishnu Priya Devi. He wanted to worship Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu anyhow managed and gave a wooden neem trees Gauranga to her anyhow, and she used to worship it. That deity anyhow after 500 years it came in the hands of my Gurudev, and now this same deity is served in our temple at Chichura. So, Vishnu Priya Devi, we should try to follow Vishnu Priya Devi. His method of Krishna remembering or his fault. Chaitanya remembering, Gauranga Deva. So, today is the birthday of Vishnu Priya Devi. We pray in her. Let us feel that. She should bestow mercy, that we have some affection and love for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the same way. If you want to be devotee like this, then Krishna will be happy, Mahaprabhu will be happy. Today is the birthday of Raghunath Das Goswami. Sankirtan should be done. Anyone? You have? Yeah? You can do. Hare Krishna? What Vishnu Priya Devi used to do? Or Gauranga Bolite? Any? No, Madanwala? You should come. Why you sit? You come after time. You should try to come in time. You can come forward here. You yourself coming forward here. Also auspicious day of Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami Maharaj disappearance day. But I think that I have told so many things about Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami first day or second day. So you remember, by the grace of Nityananda Prabhu, we have so much a strong faith in Nityananda Prabhu. By His mercy, he went to Vrindavan. He saw Vrindavan so beautiful, as it was in Krishna time. He saw Govinda Gopinath Madan Mohan. He met with Rup Sanatan. He received, he was inspired, pure Gopi Prem in his heart by Nityananda Prabhu, he has described it. Even so wretched, if anyone takes the shelter of lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu, he is Baladev Prabhu, giving spiritual strength, so he is Baladev Prabhu. If anyone takes shelter neglected by whole world, no harm Nityananda Prabhu will be merciful to him, and he will inspire everything. Today is also the birth date of Raghunath Das Goswami. We will try to remember his life, so that we may learn something, how to develop our Krishna consciousness. How he came in a very rich family, how he was married to a very beautiful lady in whole India, very beautiful and qualified. He was like a son of king, but even he left all, became street beggar, and how he received Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, lotus feet and Nityananda Prabhu, and how he became like so developed, like Raghunath Das Goswami, being in Radhapan. First he was in Puri, and then he went. He has two times darshan before giving up his all wife and wealth and everything. How he met him, and what teachings were for him from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how he met Nityananda Prabhu, how he was blessed by Nityananda Prabhu. In a very little brief, our Brahmachari Hari Priya will narrate all these things. He has heard me so many times. Naveen could have done, but he is now one-legged. So he cannot stand up. So Hari Priya should tell all the teachings and all these things, how he served Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Radha and Krishna and went to Radha. Very briefly, not so much. Give him. You can stand up. All devotees of Mathura are remembering me. Because in this very auspicious place, you want to call all, and I used to order them all Brahmachari. Oh Namin, oh Hari Priya, oh Premananda, oh Subhananda, Sudhanya, and used to tell them to speak on Raghunath Das Prabhu, Vishnu Priya Devi, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami. Oh, one thing marvelous I forget. Today is Vasanta. What is Vasanta? Pare Mavanta. What is Vasanta Panchami? Or I will tell in the last.
No,
yes. You should tell 15 minutes. It will be 7 and a half. 2 minutes I will speak on Vasanta.
ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः फर्स्ट् आफ् आल् ऐ आफर् मै अन्लिमिटेड् हम्बल् प्रोस्ट्रेटेड् ओबेसेन्सेस् टु मै स्पिरिचुवल् मास्टर् देन् टु आल् असेम्बल्ड् वैष्णवज. As per the order of Gurudev, I'll try to narrate the story of Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami was one of the principal associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who appeared in the village named Saptagram, that is in now east of West Bengal. His father, there were two brothers, Hirani Majumdar and Govardhan Majumdar. But among them, there was only one son. They were a landlord. It has been stated in Chaitanya Charitamrita that their annual income at that time was 12 lakh golden coins. They were so rich. But so you can imagine the status of Raghunath Das Goswami. When he was a child, very small, that time he got the association of Haridas Thakur. He lived with him. Haridas Thakur at that time used to live with Yadunandan Achari. Yadunandan Achari is known as his Mantra Pradata Guru, that is Diksha Guru. By the association of Haridas Thakur, he knew many things about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. By hearing about Mahaprabhu, he naturally became attracted to Mahaprabhu. Later on in his childhood, he got the chance to meet with Mahaprabhu. He wanted to leave the home, but Mahaprabhu said him, telling a verse.
First, met in Santipur, in the home of
Advaita Acharya. Mahaprabhu said that don't leave your home now. He said, reciting a prayer, Jao ghar jao na ho batul, krame krame pave tumi bhavasundukul. Don't act as a madman right now. You go back to your home. Gradually, when you will become qualified,
strong and qualified,
then you will be able to give up your material life.
What you should do?
Krami krami pave tumi bhavasindu kul.
Bhalo na khaibe ar bhalo na paribe. Amani manod bhaye trishnam sadar. Antare karanista.
Bahya lok bebhar. Achirate Krishna karibe. I explained first verse that don't act like a madman. Batul means madman. Gradually, after he said that antare karonishtha bahya lok vyavahar. Bhal na khaibe bhal na paribe. Don't eat so nice prasadam and don't wear so nicely, very opulent garments.
Don't take golden watches, golden earrings, golden so many anguthis. Holding everything, don't take delicious mahaprasada. It will make so many problems.
Antare karo nishtha.
Very costly clothes, very simple.
Antare karo nishtha bahya lok vyavahar. This is particularly the instruction for Grihastha Vaishnavas. From within your heart, you should have firm conviction, we have deep attachment with Krishna. But externally, because you are living in a society, you are not in this renounced order of life, so you have some relationship with the people of society, you act accordingly. But within inside, you should be fully dedicated to the Krishna. Antare karo nishtha bahya lok vyavahar, achirate Krishna toma koriben uddhar. Krishna, within a short period, achirat, means not in a long time, very soon he will make you cross this material world. So he was acting like that. As Gurudev said that he was married to the most beautiful woman at that time. His parents did a lot to check the Raghunath Das Goswami's feeling towards Mahaprabhu and Krishna, but ultimately they couldn't. In Panihati, we read in Chaitanya Charitamrita that Nityananda Prabhu, taking all his associates, was doing Nagar Sankirtan. He was moving village to village. When he reached to Panihati and Raghunath Das Goswami heard about this, he also went there with all his associates. He was a son of landlord, he had owned everything, armies and everything. With his associates, he went to meet Nityananda Prabhu in Panihati. There he was standing very far from Nityananda Prabhu, but Nityananda Prabhu could see him. He was not approaching Nityananda Prabhu, but Nityananda Prabhu told somebody to go and bring that boy. When he came, I'll try to say in brief. He said, "You are a thief." Why? Thief has two meanings. One is that you have not something and you try to steal something. Then you are called a thief. Other meaning that you have stolen something and you are not seeing anybody that, oh, I have stolen it. So Prabhupada says the meaning here is that Raghunath Das Goswami, he was not bereft of the Krishna prema or love towards Mahaprabhu. He had that. But he was keeping it stealthily. That's why Nityananda Prabhu told, "You are a thief." He wanted to say the glory of Raghunath Das Goswami, that he is a really bona fide devotee of Mahaprabhu. He has that love for Mahaprabhu. So he said, "You are a thief, so that I will punish you." So what will be that punishment? Raghunath Das Goswami said, "Tomorrow we will have to feed all these party, all these people who are coming in my party." What? Said dahi chura.
Same day.
Same day.
Yes.
It was dahi chura. Chura, we say flat rice plus curd and milk. So Raghunath Das Goswami, he was a rich person. He had his associates. He sent his person and they collected everything. And that day the feast was done. And there is a big story how Nityananda Prabhu called Mahaprabhu there, how people were standing in the, even they were so rush that there were no place to stand up even. They were standing in water. And everybody was fully satisfied. After
saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there from Puri at a glance, and after that he took Mahaprasadam and again he came out of sight and went to Puri. All saw that Mahaprabhu is now here with Nityananda Prabhu taking Mahaprasadam. So there was so much happiness. I'm taking the remnants of Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu.
In this way, he received the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. Like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, they say, by the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, we can cross this material world. So he also received the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. And after that, he could give up his household life. There is a story how he was acting like a material, person who is totally engaged in the household life. But inside he had that full conviction. So his father and mother, parents, they were thinking now he is a normal person, he is no more a devotee. Once in the late night, Yadunandana Acharya sent somebody to Raghunath Das Goswami.
Oh, his wife, his mother told his husband, "Why you not binding him in iron chains?" He replied that anyone cannot bind in chain and keep anyone who has some link with Chaitanya. So, what this chain which has no life can bind, even we made a very beautiful chain of his wife, very, very beautiful wife. But that chain could not bind him. So, we could not do anything. So let what Krishna has to do, and we.
One night, Yadunandana Acharya sent a person to Raghunath Das Goswami's house saying that the priest who was doing the worshipping of the deity in Yadunandana Acharya's house, he was absent, he went away. So he wanted somebody. So Raghunath Das Goswami seeking this opportunity, he went to see Yadunandana Acharya. The guards who were there, they didn't check Raghunath Das Goswami, thinking that he's going to Yadunandana Acharya's house. But Raghunath Das Goswami, he took the opportunity, and instead of going to Yadunandana Acharya's house, he left.
So he was going not through the main path. He was going through the jungle so that even if the father sends the army to catch hold of him, so he can't find him. So he was traveling to Jagannath Puri without, say, for 12 days. Within 12 days, I think he reached Jagannath Puri, and in that he took thrice or four times something like he is going somewhere, somebody is milking, he will drink the milk, that's all. No solid food. This way he reached to Jagannath Puri and surrendered himself at the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu. Then Mahaprabhu embraced him, blessed him. Then he offered Raghunath Das Goswami at the lotus feet of Swarup Damodar. There he learned all the...
What he told? When embracing?
Payadhyadhani.
Oh, you have come out of very big well of
sunset.
Tools.
Ditch.
The well is full of stools. How you can from that well? What is that tool? The love and affection for family and family love and affection. Well, so much beautiful wife, so love and affection for his parents, from others, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling it like to stool. Why? Stool is better. In one sense, that we can give up very easily. But it is very, 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 very what?
Difficult
to give up this thing. We will be entangled for all this. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling, oh, how beautiful Krishna has done mercy to you. And you have left this stone, peat, and you have come to me. At first he has warned him not to come, but now he is
encouraging.
Why? At that time he was not so strong. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw that in future he may fall, he may come to his temple. So he should be some strong. That is why he gave his chance that you should be there. Go on doing all these things, but inner, not outward. And you should not quarrel with anyone. Show that I am a very simple person, having no quality, nothing, no devotional activity. Thus they will not care for you, and you can develop in the meantime your this Krishna consciousness. And when you will be so strong, then you can easily come to it. So we should not follow the same thing. We should try to follow. We should be very strong, enough strong in Krishna consciousness. Otherwise you are seeing that so many devotees nowadays falling. We cannot rely on them, that how many days he will be in this sannyas race. We see that living in Krishna consciousness, even more than 30 years, well-honored, well-reputed person, and they go. So, generally in our line, we have never seen. But nowadays, it is going on because they are not strictly following all these things. So be in householder life and be strong, and then after that, you may be strong, then enough, you can take it in householder. otherwise no. Otherwise you will be the example of falling down, like all are here. Never. Otherwise your whole life will be spoiled. Don't try to imitate Acharya to give initiation to all. Or take first initiation and redevelop your Krishna consciousness. That by seeing you, all can tell Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So happy, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like Swamiji himself, where he went, all used to tell Hare Krishna. No use of giving them Hare Krishna mantra or initiation. This is really initiation. When heart admits that he is my guru, and that person should always give him pure Krishna consciousness. Those who are giving, what Swamiji wrote, we read, devotion. This devotion gets unalloyed devotion. He is only good. Only giving Krishna mantra in ears, I don't think that he is spiritual good, worldly good. But those who can give this unalloyed by devotion of Krishna, and my heart accept that he is my guru, then he will follow all his career. How to follow the rules and regulations? How to develop Krishna consciousness and really Krishna consciousness and his guru? So we should try to follow Raghunath Das Goswami in this. And how he, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave it in the hands of Sarup Damodar, and how he was following so Vairagya. Perhaps you know all, but he should explain something.
So in Jagannath Puri he was staying with Sarup Damodar. There he started doing very high standard of austerities, Vairagya. When his father knew that my son has gone to Jagannath Puri, he sent some servant along with some money. You go and give, if he wants to stay here, no problem. Give this money to him and he will utilize for his purpose. Raghunath Das Goswami, initially he accepted the money, but he was not utilizing for himself. He was utilizing those money for the service of Krishna. Krishna and Krishna's devotees.
And after 2 days he refused, because this is the money from Vishay. If we will use, we will also be Vishay. So we should not use to that thing. Even a grain of Vishay will make you falling down. So always be careful. Like
there is a prayer. Pisayir ann khele chitta hoy malin. Malin chitte. Haan. Pisayir ann khele malin hoy mon. Malin man hoyle Krishna na hoy smaran. If somebody is accepting something from a materialistic person and he is utilizing for himself, then his mind will become disturbed. And in such a disturbed mind, he cannot remember Krishna at all. So, hearing it, Raghunath Das Goswami stopped utilizing that money even for the service of Vaishnavas. Then he used to, when Mahaprabhu heard this, he became very happy. Then he started going, sitting at the gate of Jagannath temple in order to get some bhiksha at Singhdwar. After doing some time that, he started thinking, oh, this is like a prostitution. Every day I am sitting here, and those I'm seeing, that person gave me bhiksha yesterday. Oh, he will give me tomorrow, today also. So this is a kind of prostitution. Later on, he left that too. Now he started to take, in Jagannath temple, there's a market of prasadam. Whatever prasadam is not sold there, they just throw it away. The cows eat it. And the remnants of cows, which were really, you can say, rotten, Raghunath Das Goswami used to take those rotten rice, and he used to bring it to his own place. He'll wash it, add some salt, use it. When Mahaprabhu knew it, he became very, very glad. Once he himself came to the place where he was staying, and he was just about to have that prasadam, Mahaprabhu himself took one morsel from his plate and ate it, and he embraced Raghunath Das Goswami. He became so pleased. So this way he spent his life with Jagannath Puri. He learned all the deep secrets of bhajan from Swarup Damodar. When Mahaprabhu and his associates left this mortal world and went to the eternal abode, Raghunath Das Goswami went to Vrindavan.
Who died? Who died? Jumping in Jamuna?
There he was feeling so much separation that he was planning to suicide. He was thinking either I will throw myself from the top of Govardhan cliff, or I will throw myself in the Jamuna. So this way I will end my life. Then Raghunath Das, Sanatan Goswami and Rupa Goswami consoled him and said, no, this is not the proper way. So Raghunath Das Goswami started living at the bank of, generally he was living at the bank of Radhakund, but coming, going, always associating with Rupa and Sanatan. There I will like to say what kind of dham nishtha he had. He is praying that even throughout the day I have to talk to a materialistic person here in Braj. I would accept that, but I won't leave this Braj. This is the kind of nishtha that we require for bhajan. But he says, he depicts that it is more important of the association of Vaishnavas, because when Rupa and Sanatan departed from this material world, he says that the same Giriraj Govardhan is like a python. He is just to swallow me. So I mean, dham is really necessary, but if there is no sadhu sangha, then that dham for ordinary jivas is not so much useful. So sadhu sangha is the real thing that we should aspire for in our life. Raghunath Das Goswami is staying at the bank of Radhakund. He did a great bhajan that you all know, how he composed so many verses there. He composed Manas Diksha for us to teach the wicked mind. Many things he did. Later on, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami approached him. He taught all the teachings of Mahaprabhu and whatever he heard from Swarup Damodar to Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. And by the mercy of Raghunath Das Goswami, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami mentioned all these things in Chaitanya Charitamrita.
So, best post book is
Bilap Kushmanjali.
Raghunath Das Goswami ki
jai.
You can speak the program for today. Any program for tomorrow?
Evening there will be a program in Moolambar. That is a Red Cross building
hall
in the park, Knox Park, opposite Coles. I think all of you know where Coles is. Starting at 4:30 in the afternoon.
From here, or for their kirtan.
Yes. 4:30 in the afternoon, starting with kirtan.
From there,
in that hall. And then, in the afternoon, we will do Nagar Sankirtan, starting at about 2:30. Padmanabha Maharaj and all the enthusiastic devotees will come and enliven Moolambar. Citizens, inhabitants with the glories of the holy name, and all are welcome to come. We will arrange some transportation for that.
What time does that start, the Nagar Sankirtan?
At 2:30.
After that, about
2:30. Okay.
1 hour is
3:30
then.
3:30, assemble all at the park. Yeah.
Just coming to that
place?
Yes.
You can begin kirtan and some classes.
Okay.
And also the Ishta Goshti
tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning there will be Ishta Goshti, Urukram Prabhu.
Wow.
We've posted it on flyers. You see outside there will be an Ishtagosti at 10 o'clock in the morning tomorrow in the Pandal tent here for all the Australian-based devotees.
I'd also like to make an announcement to the disembodied voice over here in the corner. We are selling books out in front. I invite everybody. We have 4 selections of books and pictures. You can come out and talk to me. I'll turn the light on so you can see them. The other thing is we have a guest book that I'd like most people to sign. If you are new here, nobody that's traveling with Maharaj has to sign up, for those of you in Australia
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama.